Hello and welcome to you all on the Formula Sim Racing YouTube channel. My name is Jeroen Kwekel and today we are going to have a look at the first half of the 2016 Formula Sim Racing World Championship. Well, we are right in the middle and right in the summer break as well. The drivers are preparing for the second half of the season. But how did the first half of the season go? This series features one main highlight of a race, which has been driven over the course of the 2016 season so far. So in every single video, we'll be discussing one highlight out of the 8 routes being driven so far, starting off obviously with the Australian Grand Prix. In fairness, there is one highlight out of the first round of the season which really pops to mind. And that is the incredible battle between Kuba Brzezinski, Mohamed Patel and Michele D'Alessandro. It was an extraordinary battle right at the start of the season already. As the famous 5 red lights went out for the first time in the season, Baker was on pole position but immediately lost his lead to a brilliantly starting Jim Parisis. While the start was relatively clean, it was Parisis who dived into the first corner first. However, Baker did not give up and challenged Parisis immediately again, pretty much setting the tone for the rest of the race and also the highlight which is following on later. The opening lap of the 2016 season was immediately a spectacular one, with the World Championship drivers showing why they are considered as one of the best in the world. Kwekel and Parisis went side by side through 3 consecutive corners. Kwekel had the better of the two. Kwekel, however, lost his lead due to technical issues and found himself in the midfield. In approximately lap 15, Daniel Kiss spun round. While rejoining, he took Kwekel with him. A big disappointment for the Dutchman who had to retire. And so did Kiss. The absolute highlight though came in lap 39 of the race, the battle between Patel and Kuba. Later on Michele would join. During this period, Brzezinski suffered a lot of pressure from Mohamed Patel. It was after all a fight for third, later on even second. Every rule in the book was used, every single meter of the track was used, every single trick was thrown in the face of the other opponent. The newly introduced 2016 hybrid cars seem to be giving a lot of spectacle, a lot of action and a lot of great battling, with the drivers being able to use boost down the straights for an extra additional amount of horsepower. The battling was great. Take 2 World Championship drivers, 2 great World Championship drivers into account as well, Brzezinski and Patel, and what do you get? Indeed, a brilliant and nice battle. Being inches away from each other corner after corner, and being side by side corner after corner, even wheelbanging down the straights, nobody seemed to be able to give up. And it was not ended yet, as Michele D'Alessandro was now also joining in on the party after he pitted from second place. Now it was a battle for second place, as there were 3 abreast going into turn 2. Patel from Mustar Racing magically put himself in front of the 2 cars. It was Kuba now in third, but Michele had the fresher tires. Therefore, another battle opened up. Round 2, Michele D'Alessandro versus Kuba Brzezinski. Michele with the fresher tires was able to execute a perfect switchback. It gave him access to the final step of the podium. Brzezinski tried to do everything he could, but he was so close to losing the car. And that's how that battle ended.
I spent the entire first part of the race watching Kuba easily hold off Bigazzi, so I was very aggressive with the boost to try a pass after the pit stop. I tried everything and thought the opportunity had gone, but in the end I got fortunate with Michele exiting the pits and knew that this was my one clear chance, and luckily I took it. It was one of quite a few great battles I've had with Kuba over the last year and a half, every one being just as intense.
After 58 laps it was Jim Parisis who saw the checkered flag first. After 305 kilometers, he was the first to cross the finish and take home the first victory. That concludes it for the first highlight after the first round of the season. The highlight, Brzezinski Patel D'Alessandro, is definitely one which will stay in the books. Have you got a recommendation on what highlight we should pick? You can leave them down below in the comment section if you want, and we'll consider picking it. Next highlight will feature content from the second round being driven at Bahrain. I thank you all for watching. If you have enjoyed the video, we would sincerely appreciate a like. Would you like to get involved in FSR? Please check the description for our website, our Facebook page, our Twitter page, and get in touch with us. Thanks again. Have a good day.